I want to learn the lesson of forgiveness. So you decide, I want to learn the lesson of forgiveness. So in the realm of souls, there are some higher souls, which we call our higher self, we call them angels, you can call them your devtas, you can call them masters, guardians, in different fields in the world, they give them different names. So they are the ones who help you and guide you. So you say, I want to learn the lesson of forgiveness. So the master says, okay, we'll see what is available and what scripts are available. It is almost like you think of a movie. First, the script is written. The script is written for you, you are the main actor in that movie. And the director usually casts set number of people. And these people who are there in your life, at the realm also, they are known as the soul. And they tend to reincarnate again and again in your life. So they may play your wife, may have been your mother, may have been your daughter, may have been your friend, in a different past life. So the roles keep changing, but the scripts also keep changing, but the soul group remains more or less the same. And there are some people who come who are not in your soul group, they come as guest appearance. So in your life also they will come as guest appearance doing something. So you want to learn the lesson of forgiveness and you have a script which is ready. And suppose you are born as a girl, and one of your soul group says, okay, I'll go down as your husband and I'll be a very bad husband. I will trouble you a lot. Just see if you can forgive me. So you come down. You have a very nice childhood, loving parents, you get married. After some time your husband starts shouting. He starts drinking, beating you up, neglecting you, basically making life difficult. So you have two options. You leave him, take a divorce, that is you leave the school. Okay, lesson not learned. Or you continue because you have children, you can't leave the children. You pass the rest of your life always saying, God, please give me a better husband in my next life. So after you die, you go up, your husband says, I troubled you a lot. Did you forgive? Then, okay, lesson not learned. No problem. There is no such thing as time, it is only lessons. Life is only lessons. So you come down, young child, mother dies. Father demands, you get a stepmother. Now stepmother makes life very difficult. The moment you become big, you leave your home, go away, and you keep saying, if my mother would have been alive, I would have been in a better position, would have been done. But it is because of this lady, my stepmother, our life has been spent. Go up. He doesn't ask you. Did you forgive me? Same lesson, third script. Good childhood, good husband, good children, very nice life, comfortable. You become old, children leave you. You are in old age home, nobody can look after you. Sick, tired, children are all gone away. You say, God, it was better you did not leave me children until you did this. When you go up, you don't ask. Pity for you. So if you just look around in your life, all around. Mother-in-law, daughter-in-law, husband, wife, brothers, partners in business, friends. There is a constant struggle. But if you look at the larger picture, everybody is doing what they are supposed to do. So if nobody does bad to you, how do you forgive that person? You chose to learn the lesson of forgiveness. Something bad will happen to you, and then you will learn the lesson of forgiveness. So, whatever happens in our life in school, we have chosen these things to happen. The script is written by us. And this is just a simple part. You have multiple options. You will see the first lesson which you are taught is in a very gentle way. Someone does bad to you, usually is a friend you know for some time. You didn't learn the lesson, you go away from it. Don't know. Then it so happens then it is brother Gandhi. Stop talking to your brother. Neighbor. Parents, you leave the house. Neighbor, wife. Neighbor, children. Eventually you will have to learn this. So these things keep happening. It is whatever is happening is happening. There is no right or wrong. Right or wrong is just a perspective of how we are being taught. Whatever happens in our life, we react to the situation with the knowledge which we have. And the moment we react, we create a bondage. The moment you say something and I react, you call me a name. That is reaction. You don't want to fight. You call me a name, I feel very bad. But I don't say it. Even that is reaction. When you react, emotions start rising. And these emotions which arise, these are all the negative emotions. Irritation, frustration, anger, helplessness, depression. So where have they arisen from? By your reaction, what somebody has said or what something is going on. Now these negative emotions have been created. These are all energies. Now these energies will have to manifest. Where will they manifest? These are within you. They will manifest within you. You will start getting an idea. You will start getting a backache. Chronic joint pains. Stomach upset. Now this continues. High blood pressure. So all energies manifest at the mental level. Eventually at the physical. So I call the body is actually a reflection of the mind. Whatever happens in the body, the source is in the mind. And what is the mind? We talk about what is the mind. Mind is only a collection of thoughts. If there are no thoughts, there is no mind. For convenience sake, just for this thing. So we divide the mind into two parts. The smaller part is the conscious mind. Conscious mind is the mind which you are aware of. All that you remember in the present. What you do, what you wear, who is your friend, who is not your friend. And that conscious mind exists till you exist in the physical. Now below that there is a larger part which we call the subconscious mind, which actually is like a hard disk, a storehouse of the journey of your soul. Everything that your soul has done, seen, experienced is written down in the subconscious. And that subconscious is a part of the soul. So whenever you take birth again and again, the subconscious remains with you. And collects. So whatever you have learned over years has been already recorded in your subconscious. So now, if you are born over here, this is a school, and you have come having learned this lessons like someone knows how to forgive, someone is generous, or somebody gets very angry. So everybody has learned a few lessons. And a few lessons are yet to be learned. So I call this a school, from nursery to graduation. Normally people who are here, they are all somewhere in middle high school, 6, 7, 8, 9. You have learned a large number of lessons, some more lessons are yet to be learned. But society is a mixture, it's a school. So there are people who are in nursery also, there are people who are highest last classes, about to graduate. So, if you have learnt a few lessons, suppose you are in class 6, so you know a few things, but you get married to a person who is in